Kuzuzanpo, and welcome to the Rigsum Sherig Collection 2.0. If you're watching this video, you're probably post the installation stage. Congratulations! The Rigsum Sherig Collection includes a bunch of offline resources, all available offline without the need for internet. The two main resources are Wikipedia and Khan Academy. Wikipedia is an electronic encyclopedia. It allows us to browse many, many articles on different topics. We have three selections of articles. The first one is called Wikipedia Selection for Schools. This includes over 6,000 articles on different topics that are useful, especially in school. We can search by subjects by clicking on the subject index. We can search by countries, by citizenship, art, etc. If you're interested in searching other databases, you can go to File, Open File, and click on any one of these three files here will allow you to search different collections of articles. Wikipedia allows teachers to assign research. Children can go and search for information on Wikipedia and bring it back to class. They can also further explore by clicking on different links and articles. That's Wikipedia in a nutshell. Our second resource is Khan Academy. Khan Academy offers over 2,000 videos in maths and sciences. Each video is about 10 minutes long and concentrates on a particular topic. The math videos start from very simple math, PP level, all the way up to high school and even college level. For example, we can see a video here on addition. We can play the video.
What I want to do in this video.
Skip.
Plus 8 is 70.
Pause.
And that's just a little bit of warm-up.
And go back and forth as we like. You can control the volume here, which means you probably want a headset. And teachers can also click the full screen to help them and project a certain video in class. The sciences videos are more appropriate for high school level. Physics, chemistry, biology, and more. That is the Khan Academy in a nutshell. The next resource is called the Curriculum Bookshelf, and what it includes are a bunch of ebooks. We have books by Ministry of Education's Curriculum Development Department, including textbooks and workbooks for classes PP to 6, information about book lists, lab supplies, and syllabus. We also have some books by the DDC in Dzongkha. Lastly, we have some sample exam papers. If you're planning to go up for board exams this year, this is an interesting folder to check out. We have exams from the website of the Ministry of Education, as well as by different high schools who've posted sample papers. Next, we have audiobooks. Audiobooks allow you to listen to several classic books, poetry, and some poems. Within each one of these books, you'll find an ebook file that will allow you to read the book. And after that, you'll find different chapters in audio.
This is a LibriVox recording. He had a dirty little room close by the pigsty.
Different chapters are read by different people with different accents, so you can learn different styles of reading and understand different accents. In addition to books, as I mentioned, we have some poetry, and these are poems that are actually in the syllabus, in the curriculum. And lastly, lots of nice poems that every child should know. Next, we have four Dzongkha resources. We have three dictionaries by the DDC. The first one is the Children's Dzongkha Dictionary. What's nice about this dictionary is that in addition to telling you what the word means and what it means in English, you can even click and listen.
Nyamgi.
It will tell you what the word sounds like.
Nimi yuzer.
The other two dictionaries are Dzongkha English and English Dzongkha Dictionaries. Lastly, if you always wanted to learn how to type in Dzongkha, this is your chance. The DZ Type Dzongkha Typing Tutor will teach you how to type in Dzongkha. To learn how to type in Dzongkha, use the typing tutor. You'll have to type in the big white window what you see at the top small window. For example, now I need to type Giku. If I'm not sure where it is, I can click here and get the hint. I'll have to first change my keyboard to Dzongkha and then start typing. In no time, you'll learn how to type in Dzongkha. The next set of resources are several different games. The first one is called Cetera, and it's a geography quiz game. You can quiz yourself and find out what you know about capitals, rivers, countries, and all kinds of different geography questions. Next is Child's Play. Child's Play will teach young children how to use a mouse and keyboard and how to identify digits and letters, all in a playful way with lots of games. The next resource is called Open Office for Kids. Similar to Microsoft Office, it has spreadsheets and PowerPoint type applications. Unlike Office, this is more suitable for young children. Bigger buttons, more appealing colors, and easier to navigate. If you wanted to learn how to play chess, this is your chance. Dream Chess will let you play against a computer so that you can learn how to play chess. And Scratch. Scratch is a software to learn how to program. Friendly for children and easy to learn. Lastly, we have a bunch of utilities down here that you can use aside from the Rigsum Sherig Collection. We have the browser, Google Chrome. Picasa is used for editing photos. Adobe Reader is used for reading PDF files. VLC Media Player plays the audio books that we talked about earlier. And Audacity is a tool for editing sound. If you have a music club, this is a good place to explore. If you have any more questions, you can join our Facebook group, and there's more information if you click on the Rigsum Sherig Collection 2.0 icon up here. To find out how to register, click on this page. You can join our Facebook group and share your experiences, photos, and how you'd like to use the Rigsum Sherig Collection. More information is also available on this small website. Happy learning and tashi delay from the Rigsum Sherig team.